My dear friends, Mary Magdalene tells the disciples of our Lord, the apostles, I have seen the Lord. I have seen the risen Lord. We hear about that the Lord cast out 7 devils from her. And the Lord himself had said, when people criticize him, if only he knew who this woman is, what kind of sinner she is. And then the Lord said to the one who repents is forgiven more. And to her, my dear brothers and sisters, the privilege was given. The risen Lord appeared to her first and asked her, go and tell my disciples, I have risen. Go and proclaim to the world that I am alive, I am risen. This was the privilege the Lord gave to her. My dear friends, it is not what kind of person one is, but what kind of person he becomes. She accepted that she was a sinner. She came to know Christ. She saw Christ as a Christ and a human person. And she was touched by him, by his love, by his forgiveness, by his mercy and teaching. She was attracted by Christ's teaching. And this is why she goes publicly, accepts that she was a sinner, repents her sinfulness, and turns to the Lord. My dear friends, that is what we are all called upon to be. I just want to place before you, the scripture says 7 devils are cast out from her. What are the names of the 7 devils? My dear friends, these 7 devils are 7 capital sins which the Catechism of the Catholic Church speaks about, which we should know. And all of us have those devils in us, want it or not. Let me read out to you what are these 7 capital sins and examine ourselves whether little of it is in us. First, the pride. The pride. Can anyone else say, including me, that we are not proud? Yes, God given gifts we should be proud about. So thank God for all that he is to us. Because we have been called by him to love him and serve him. But to boast about that and not accept that's a gift of God is something sinful. Whatever we are is a gift that comes from above. And that we should all praise and thanks should go to God alone. Second, covetousness. We are so selfish. Everything we want to ourselves. Who is not selfish? Me and my own is today my family, my children, my house, my job, my money, everything as if we have brought that. It's all, it's a gift of the Lord. And we have been given that, not as owners, but as trustees, to be used for, first, for the service of people. If that is in us, then we will be generous in our life. As opposite to the pride, you will be humble enough to accept what the Lord has granted to us. Third, the capital sin, the lust. Yes, we have to guard our eyes, guard our thoughts, guard our ears, and guard everything in us that leads us to sin. The lust today has broken our families. The lust today has changed the name of marriage. Lust today has gone to that extent that people forget they are human being, the children of God, and many a times they live like animals. Want it or not, that is what is happening in the world today. But on the other hand, the gift of chastity that the Lord gave us is a gift that should be respected and loved. While God created man and woman and blessed them and said, increase and multiply, He blessed them. But today, that blessing we misuse to our own selfish ends. Fourth, the capital sin, the devil, is the anger. The anger. We have plenty of it in all of us. And that is what today spoils us in our life and breaks our relationship. And this is why we are called upon to be meek and humble of heart like Jesus Christ. But Lord also was angry at one time. Rightful anger. And that when He was slapped. On that night when He was redeeming us of His passion and death. Why do you slap me? If I have spoken the truth, was the question that God asked. Yes, righteous anger is all right. But anger, for anger's sake, will not take us anywhere. And this is why we are all called upon to be like Jesus Christ, meek and humble of heart. The lamb that was led to the crucifixion. Not that we have to be led to the crucifixion, but we have that spirit of meekness in us, which will win over every heart. My dear friends, the fifth capital sin is gluttony. People today in the world, yes, go hungry. Hungry. There's no food to eat. There are many, many people who do not even have one meal a day. But there are a small section of people, maybe even among us, want to eat and eat and eat, and do not even share a little bit with our brothers and sisters who die of hunger next door. And this is why that is Holy Father calls it waste of food. It's a sin. And the gluttony is one of the capital sins because of that. Sixth capital sin is envy. We do not want our neighbor next door prosper in life. We don't want a servant child get better marks than our own children. We do not want someone has a better car, better house or something. Envy of others. Why? Everyone is given gifts. The Lord says, some is given 10 talents, 5 talents, 1 talent. The Lord himself speaks, different people are given different talents. What is more important is that we work on those talents and make those talents fruitful rather than envy others, which never envy. And enviness becomes, instead of brotherly love, we kill our relationship by envy. Lastly, the capital sin, sloth. The opposite of sloth is diligence. Sloth, yes, we are so careless. We don't go careless about others. We are not diligent enough to live like children of God, as brothers and sisters, as the people, community of the faithful. My dear friends, these are the 7 devils the Lord cast out from Mary Magdalene. Today, as you are gathered here for this celebration and reflect on the theme, look to him and be radiant. Unless we cast out these demons, these devils from our life, how could we be radiant of Christ in our life and be humble, be generous, be chaste, be meek, be transparent, share the brother's love, and be diligent? How can we be? Because Christ was full of that. And this is why we are called upon in today's world to be Christ-like. Be radiant in everything that we do. Every day, from the morning to evening, when we act, think, and do anything, we should have a thought, am I radiating Christ in my life? Am I giving Christ to others? Am I establishing God's kingdom of love in this world? And am I building the community of the faithful of love, peace, and justice? If these thoughts come to us, I am sure in our life we will look at Christ and radiate Christ in our society and everywhere. Secondly, my dear friends, I said this year we are celebrating the centenary year of our appearance of Our Lady at the Fatima. You know, Jesus has given us his mother as our mother. We should be thankful to Jesus for this gift of Mary, our mother. And she's always concerned about us. Always concerned about our children. Like any earthly mother is concerned. Much more than that, she's concerned of our spiritual welfare. Of our spiritual welfare. It was in 1917. The third year of this First World War. When the world was in war and there was no peace, people were dying. It is said 80 lakhs people died. 8 million people died in the First World War. And while whole world was going to this turmoil, Our Lady appears in that small village of Fatima in Portugal to the three children. And there she appears 6 times consecutively on the 13th of every month, beginning from May 13th. And what was her message? Message was very, very simple. Call for the peace in the world. Call for the consecration of the world to Mother Mary. And specifically, at that time, it was mentioned, Russia. Call for penance. Call for the prayer and sacrifice. And on the last day, 13th of October, when she appeared, she spoke about, I am the Lady of Holy Rosary. At Lourdes, she has said, I am the Lady of Immaculate Conception. She herself confirmed what the church had declared, that she was without sin. And here, Mary tells those three children, Lucia, Francisco, and Jacinta, she tells those three children, I am the Lady of Holy Rosary, and calls upon them to tell the whole world to recite this Holy Rosary. Because in this rosary, we reflect the mystery of our salvation. Mysteries of our salvation. And we join in that with the Lord and Mother Mary. When we recite, all of us know, family that prays together stays together. And this is why Mary gave an appeal to recite the rosary. My dear friends, I always appeal to you and appeal to everyone. You want to be united in your family? You know, you want the peace in your family. You want the children to obey you. You want God to bless you. Hold on to the rosary, the simplest of prayers. And you will see the miracles the Lord works in your family and in your life. No one who intercedes with Mother Mary will go unheeded, because she will be there pleading with our son Jesus for us and for our family. She will not let us down. As a good mother given to us by Jesus Christ. And this is why in my circular, my dear friends, I had announced in the month of May as the Holy Father had appealed. Let me tell out to you, read out to you. Receive the communion as often as possible. This was an appeal given by her. And in a special way, reparation and receiving of the communion on first Saturday. Second, act of consecration, entrustment to God through the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We should consecrate ourselves, our families, our parish, our diocese for this purpose. And also have some kind of sign of a Christianity, and especially the brown scapular, as a sign of the consecration and needs to be propagated. Because Mother Mary has said, whoever wears this scapular will be protected from sin and from damnation. Fourthly, meditate on the Holy Rosary as often as possible. Next, reparation, adoration, we should undertake so that we make reparation for the sinfulness of ourselves and of the world. Today, as we celebrate the centenary, Holy Father has called upon at the diocesan level, at the parish level, at the family level, we should consecrate ourselves to Our Lady of Fatima and experience her love and protection. In many of the dioceses, Our Lady statue of Fatima is reckoned round to the parishes, to the families, to experience this love. In our own archdiocese, we have two parishes dedicated to Our Lady of Fatima, Our Lady of Fatima Church, Jalahalli, and the Our Lady of Fatima Church, Hoskote. And this year, whoever makes a pilgrimage to these two churches, and also to the three shrines, that they can obtain a plenary indulgence, provided they fulfill the conditions that are laid on for the obtaining of the plenary indulgence. My dear friends, today in a special way, when we reflect on this day, the centenary celebration of the apparition of Our Lady of Fatima, let us entrust ourselves to the care of Mother Mary. Let us entrust our diocese. Let us entrust our parishes. Let us entrust our families. Let us entrust our priests and the religious and the everyone in the diocese. And ask Mother Mary to bless us, to protect us, and lead us on the right path, so that always we may do His will. Remember what Mother Mary said to the people at the wedding of Cana: do what my son tells you. Let us keep our hearts, our ears open, and listen what Jesus is going to tell us today and every day of our life, and we will be able to respond to His appeal to us, to His inspiration to us. May Mary, our mother, intercede for us with our son, Jesus. Amen.